The concept of this video applies most with people in their 20s and 30s. The concept of this video applies most with people who are single and without kids. These two steps will be difficult for people with a spouse and kids. This is only for people who want a better future. I'm a real estate investor, so my channel's investment strategy will be heavily real estate focused. This video is about opportunity cost. The title may seem like clickbait in a get-rich-quick scheme, but it certainly is not. What are you willing to give up today in order to live a prosperous life tomorrow? Opportunity cost is basically what gain could you have received if you selected a different option. If you select option A, what gain could you have received if you would have selected option B instead? We're confronted with many decisions daily, but rarely do we take the time to analyze how our decisions affect our future. Sure, people spend time looking at the big picture items, what college to go to, what degree path do we select, or who to marry, but how many times do you analyze smaller decisions? Do you live with roommates? Do you choose to live closer to work to save money on gas? Do you replace restaurant dining with learning how to cook? These seemingly smaller decisions can have profound impacts on our future lives. Since I've seen so many articles recently on how many millennials are worried about retirement, how many millennials believe they won't retire, and how much nonsense information is being spouted on why millennials can't retire, I'm going to simply cut through the BS and give you my simple two-step method to having $1 million for retirement. We're setting the retirement age anywhere between 60 and 65. Step 1. Get your living expenses to $0 a month. Step 2. Cut your car expense to as low as possible. Since this video will also serve as a case study, I'm going to provide numbers I've seen recently from coworkers and friends. Meet Kim. Kim graduated college a few years ago with a degree in marketing. She is now 25 and wants to live by herself in an apartment. Because she recently accepted a job as marketing assistant at a local tech company, her salary is now $40,000 a year. Feeling the lifestyle inflation itch, she decides to buy a new 2020 Toyota Camry from her local dealership for $30,000. She wants to live close to work and found a nice apartment that will cost her $1,000 a month total for rent, utilities, electric, and internet. I will be comparing this person to my setup as I think that's the only fair way to make this video. I cash flow from living in my house, so I actually make money while living. But for this video, let's just assume my living expenses are $0 per month. This is a scam, Spencer. How does someone live for free? This is called house hacking and something I'll be talking about in abundance on this channel. This strategy is where you buy a house and rent out your rooms. If done correctly, your living expenses will decrease dramatically. If you follow what I will be talking about on this channel, your expenses will go to $0 every month, and in some rare cases, you will cash flow. Additionally, I paid $6,500 for a used 2011 Ford Fusion, 100K miles with no warranty. I'll add in $3,500 over the next 5 years in repairs to get my total cost of car ownership to $10,000. This will serve as a comparison to Kim, who spent $30,000 on a car over the same 5 year period. I won't include the increase in insurance and registration for her new car, even though that could total a few thousand dollars over a 5 year period. Over this 5 year period, Kim will spend $60,000 on living expenses and $30,000 on car expenses. Over the same time frame, I will spend $0 on living expenses and only $10,000 on car expenses. This is a total difference of $80,000. Let's head over to a compound interest calculator to show you the opportunity cost of Kim's decisions versus mine. The year is now 2025 and I have $80,000 to invest that Kim does not have because she didn't watch my videos. There will be no monthly contributions. The point of this exercise is basically to show you the power of compound investing. And at the time of this exercise, Kim was 25, so we're gonna do in 5 years when her car payment is up. The goal is to see what her retirement account would have when she's 60 years old. We're gonna plug in an estimated interest rate of 6%. Now this is really on the low end. This would be like low risk index funds, and we'll be compounding the interest annually. So this is just a thought experiment. Keep in mind, that's what it is. So $460,000 is what Kim would have when she's looking to retire at 60 years old. She would have $460,000 in her account. That all started from the $80,000 that I discussed she could have if she were to make just two simple decisions. Now, Spencer, the title of the video is about having $1 million in retirement. So how does she do that? Well, if you think about it like this, the stock market over time generally gets 8 to 10%. So let's just plug in 8% is the interest rate. Now we're all of a sudden at $800,000. You can see the power of compounding because each year the account grows more and more and more. And once you get to about year 22, 24, 26, the account starts to grow tremendously. Look at this growth, right? The power of compound investing over time. Now let's assume that she would want to retire at 65 now. So we'll give it another 5 years. And again, this is just a fun experiment to show you the power of compound investing. Now we're at 1.2 million. So as you can see with this calculator, really it's the power of overtime investing with that initial investment being 80,000. So if she's interested in real estate, you know, and upwards of 15%, if she holds these properties right? Your mortgage lasts 30 years. If she holds this properties for 30 years and the mortgage is paid off, so you get mortgage pay down from your tenants and you get, let's just call it like 1 or 2% a year of appreciation, which over time is the general rule of thumb. I mean, 15% is on the low end with real estate investing. You're talking about $5.3 million. So again, this is not a video aimed at telling you exactly how much you'd have. I know that life happens and there are plenty of things that can throw you off the path, but the point of the video is to really open up your mind to what is possible if you make a couple of decisions today. In this video, I'm only talking about two, simply lowering your living expenses and lowering your expenses towards your car. And you're talking about potentially $80,000 over 5 years. And this doesn't even include the fact that I cash flow on my house. And if you do the real numbers on someone like some of my coworkers or friends that I have that are more in the 100,000 range over the next 5 years of difference in expenses, even with 15% for real estate, I mean, look at the difference. We're talking 6.6 million. I mean, that's a huge retirement account just from these decisions and with no monthly contributions. So please feel free. If you have any comments, please let me know what you think. I know this is a very simple video for a lot of you. The point of this video is for the couple of you that are not aware of compound interest or not aware that just a couple simple decisions today could have a profound impact on your ability to retire. And not only that, but also the amount of money that will be in your retirement account.